Hello and welcome back to the Homestead. Hey, we're rolling sods. Birds on the homestead. Some people will consider them unwelcomed guests. Other people will love to have their presence. Birds are very important at eating slugs, aphids, even some of the good bugs that you have if you have an imbalance. Now, birds are also good for aerating the soil and eating weed seeds. They get on the ground, they scratch around, they start eating things that we can never see, little minute things. If you've got chickens, you know what I'm talking about. We're going to build a house in a little bit. I'm going to show you how to welcome those birds. We're also going to encourage bird baths. Now with bird baths, those birds will get in that water, they'll manure that water, plant around your bird baths. Put out a dozen, half dozen if you don't have the space, and fill those things daily with fresh water. They'll get in there, they'll splash around, they'll clean themselves, they'll manure that water, and that water will splash off onto other things. Now keep in mind that certain times of the year you want to protect. Apple trees, crows, and your magpies and whatnot, they'll get in there and they'll peck those things and it'll drive you nuts. So use some caution. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to cater to certain birds. We're gonna build bird houses and bird baths. They're gonna eat those little larvae in the ground, worms and things that would normally get in and help themselves to our produce. Those birds will help clean those out. You have to use caution. This by no means is an extensive lesson on birds on the homestead. We have no time nor knowledge. I do know this, that in all the years that I've been gardening, I've never had birds devastate my garden, nor put a dent in it to where I've actually wanted to keep birds out of my garden. So from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna build ourselves a little birdhouse, just like this one. It's gonna be cheap, it's gonna be easy, single piece of pine, few tools, nothing to it. Let's get started. Again, with the messy garage, still moving in, lots of things to do, getting ready to put the garden in. For this birdhouse, what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our supplies together. A single piece of pine wood like this, a 6 foot long, 5 foot would be sufficient, 6 inches wide, 1 inch thick. Now, keep in mind, this is under today's standard. What is a 2x4? It's not a 2x4. What is a 6x1? Not a 6x1. If we actually measure, we're looking at a little less than a 5.5 inches. What a rip, right? Less than a half inch here, probably, I don't know, 3/4 inch, not fully an inch. Regardless, it is 6 foot tall, so that's pretty good. We're not gonna use the whole 6 foot board, but a board like this at Home Depot, probably $350, $375, very cheap, get you one for this. Now, another thing we're gonna need is a hole driller for our drill. It's 1.5 inch hole. We're gonna put that in the front a little bit later, but a drill bit, something like that right there for 1.5 inch hole, that's gonna do the trick. Bigger holes for bigger birds, depending on what you're trying to lure to your property, you're gonna need a tape measure. Small tape measure will do just fine. This is a 12 foot. Optional, but not required, clamps. Second video I've brought out where I've showed where we need clamps. These things will save you a lot of aggravation. So get you some clamps, optional. Now I have some leftover 2 inch decking screws and I'm gonna use these. These were where I put the fence up with. I'm gonna use these to put this particular birdhouse together. Finishing nails would be just fine, except for one thing. You're gonna wanna put screws in the front of your birdhouse. This is the way you can take the front off to clean it each year. If you nail that dude in, you're gonna have some problems. You're gonna need a dowel rod. And it doesn't really matter what size. Too big, not good. Too little, not good either. What you wanna do is you wanna find you a drill bit and a dowel rod that are the same dimensions, and we'll show you this in a minute. You're gonna wanna have a straight edge of some sort, and I'm gonna use this angle right here, it's gonna work just perfect. Now, the power tools that are nice to have, of course, I'm gonna say required is this one, is your drill. If you don't have your drill, you're gonna have a hard time. So get you a drill, doesn't have to be a battery, it could be a power off the plug, just get a drill. The next one is a miter saw. I use a miter saw to make my cuts so they're nice and smooth, but you can use a hand saw in a miter box if you've got a miter box wide enough. A hand saw and a couple saw horses work just fine, but I'm going to be using a miter saw for this particular project. Another piece of equipment that's real nice to have is a pilot hole drill bit. Any drill bit would work, provided that it's just a hair smaller than the diameter of the screws you're using. You still want some bite when you get ready to screw that thing in. Now we're going to make some marks on our board. Take your tape measure, lock it in on one side. Keep a little distance right here. Run it down to the end, lock it in place so the tape rests on the board itself. We're going to make marks. This side is going to be different than this side. First mark at 10 inches. So we're going to take our trusty pencil at 10 inches. 20 inches would be the second mark. The next mark at 27 3/4 inches. 27 3/4, pretty simple. The next one at 35 3/4, going down to 35 3/4. The next one would be 45 3/4, going down to 45 3/4. And the last one at 49 3/4. 49 3/4. Going to the other side of the board. We're going to lay our tape out that just like that, and we're going to make our first one at 10 inches, similar to the other side, but not quite. 20 inches is our second mark. The third mark at 27 3/4. 27 3/4. Here's where we run different. 37 3/4, down to 37 3/4, and 45 3/4. 45 3/4. Last one at 49 3/4. 49 3/4. Measure twice, cut once. Check all your measurements. Very nice. Now we're going to take our straight edge and we're going to make ourselves some lines. Now there's really a lot of different ways that you can do this, but the best way is to cut your end off, the part that you're not going to use, and reduce the length of the board. This way it makes it easier to work with. Now when you get down to these two with the angle between them, save that for the very last. Now the smallest piece is going to be your floor. We're going to want to cut these little pieces off the edge. Really a good measurement would probably be about a half inch to an inch, cutting at an angle at 45 to open up that bottom part. It's going to be unseen, so I like to make it perfect, but it doesn't have to be. Now we're getting ready to have a little fun. We've got our bottom, our back, and that's the second to the smallest piece. We got our front, which is a piece like that, and an equal piece, which is going to be our roof. And then, of course, the two sides, our angles. I'm going to show you on this other birdhouse I've got. If you'll see here, I've got an overhang to keep the moisture out, but I've also got a little area in the back, too. Now, I've got some pilot holes drilled here in this one to bolt against a post. If you don't want it all the way to the top of the post, where the post is resting right here, down, where this is the top of the post, then you'll need to make your roof flush against the base. But I'm gonna leave mine overhang to let the water drip off and then down the back of the post. We're gonna inset our bottom, and I'll show you how to do that in just a little bit. First thing you wanna do is get one of your sides and lay it down. Take the front, put that flush on the surface in front of your side. Then you want to take your back just like that. Level everything from the back, or from the bottom rather, this side from the bottom. Now we take our clamp. And we tighten it up. Cinch it till it just holds it. Make sure everything is flush, dress right, dress. Take your other side, and by this point, you're going to be able to kind of wedge it where the friction will hold it together for the most part. But see, it's kind of loose. It's not a problem. we'll take our other clamp, and in the middle, right here, bring that in, cinch it up. Bring everything flush. Nice. Like we used to say in the Army, dress right, dress. Get that dude locked in. Pop this one. Friction should hold it together. Let's cross our fingers. Just like that. Dress right, dress, dress right, dress. Everything's good. I like that a lot. Now what we're going to do is we're going to drill some pilot holes. We're going to get this thing kind of halfway screwed together. So you don't have to be perfect, but just realize that you're going to be closer to the side than you think. And so you want to drill as close to the middle as you can. Now when considering your pilot bit, you want this thing to be about as long as your screw is long. You don't want your wood to split. You don't want your pilot bit to be too narrow or too thick. Just right. Now, what is just right? Just right is almost as big as your screw, but not quite. Just enough to give the threads good enough bite. Drill four of them on the back, four of them on the front. Now, when considering where to put your screws on the front, it's very important to remember that we're going to use screws and not finishing nails so we can take the front off, and we're going to take it off sooner than you think, and I'll show you why in a minute. But you're going to have screws coming in from the top, and you want to make sure that's for the roof, and you want to make sure that those screws don't go so far down that you hit the other screws. So I kind of come down a little bit farther on my pilot holes, just about in these 4 points. Now, once you get your pilot holes drilled, go ahead and train your drill bit and get ready to screw things in. I'm going to give you a word of warning. Go slow. If you go too fast, you're going to bolt it through, and if you do, you're going to crack your wood. Now on the front, I'm not going to cinch it in too tight because I'm going to pull this off in just a little bit. On the back, however, I'm going to cinch it in and I'm going to leave it forever and ever in a world without end. Now that we have our front and our back on, we're going to put our bottom on. And this is going to be a little bit different, but nothing we can't handle. Now keep in mind, we need the front of the birdhouse to be removable. You know, periodically we need to remove that. Additionally, that leftover piece of wood that we had, you can also make different birdhouses out of the same birdhouses by drilling a bigger hole in your birdhouse. Now this piece should fit very, very tightly. If it doesn't fit, get your sander out or take your miter saw and whittle just a little bit off. But it's going to fit pretty snug. You're going to have some spacing. These pine boards are never, you know, square. They always have a twist or a turn in them. And so you want to inset that, maybe a half inch, three quarter inch, nothing to be worried about as far as that's concerned. Just go ahead and sink it in there a little bit where there's like an edge, maybe up to your first knuckle or halfway. Doesn't have to be perfect. These holes are going to allow for air movement and also moisture. If it gets in there, it's going to be able to drain out. We're going to punch our pilot holes on the side and screw it in from the side. Two holes should do the trick. No need to put holes on all four corners, especially not on the front, because the front we're going to remove, and the sides, I mean, it's birds. How heavy can they be? Now, with a guesstimate, you may run into some problems about where to drill your pilot hole. And that's not really a big issue. You just measure your guesstimate. I got a half inch there. We know that we got 3/4 of an inch. So we take half of 3/4 of an inch, add another half inch, and we're good to go. It's a guesstimate. If you punch through in the wrong place, it's okay. More air, the better. I think we hit that knot hole right there. Love that smell. That pine knot smell. Suggestion, once you get one pilot hole drilled on the bottom, go ahead and change your drill bit out and secure it in. That way you won't lose your place if it gets shifted. Little space right here, not a big deal. Once you get your bottom on, we're going to get our top done. We can go ahead and pop our clamps. I'm going to change the angle of the video to kind of show you how I'm going to set the roof of this particular birdhouse. Now, like I was saying before, if you want this thing to be flush,
where the back is up against a post, make sure that there's nothing in the way. Even if you bring this edge down to this point, this little angle is going to be in the way. I'm going to set this at the top of a post, so I'm going to space it somewhat even in between. You don't need to use your clamp on this. It's at an angle, so it's going to be much more difficult to use your clamp. We're going to set one hole, and then we're going to go ahead and secure it, and the rest of them will work together as we go along. Now I'm going to show you something about drilling at an angle. Now set your roof like you want it, just like that. Hold that down with your hand. Find out where you want your hole. It's going to be right about there. But don't try to drill it like this. Come at it at 90 degrees to the pitch of the roof. Start your hole, and then once you get it started, then turn up. Watch how I'm doing this. Watch. There you go. Now, once you get that first one done, keep your hand on it. Have somebody help you or whatever you need. And you want to lock it in with your first screw. Now don't worry about this screw coming in at an angle. It's fine. Nothing wrong with that. Go in slow. And just leave it just like that for now. Now I'm going to show you that technique again up close and personal. Now the birdhouse pitch is at an angle. And we want to put our drill bit at 90 degrees to that angle, not 90 degrees to our surface, our table. Now the reason for that, if you try to do this, that bit's going to roll down and it's going to cause you to say an ugly word. So start at an angle and get some bite into the wood and then move it back up to go straight down. Let me show you again. There you go, just like that. Go slow. There, it's at an angle there. There's a little lip on it, but there's nothing wrong with that. It's fine. Nice and flush on this side. Good. So now we got our roof on. We got our floor on, sides, front. Looking somewhat like a birdhouse, I tell you what. So now we're going to deal with the front of the birdhouse. We need to drill our hole the bird's going to go into. And then we also need to drill the one where our little roost is going to come so they have something to land on. Of course, not this long. So let's get started with that. Now, I like things to be centered. I don't like dealing with oblong or things that aren't quite dress. If it's not straight, it's all right. Bird will find its way in there regardless. So what I do is you measure across. You got a little less than 5.5 inches. Come up to your halfway mark. I'm going to say 2.5 would be half of 5, 2¾-ish, and I think you're fine. Keep your finger there. Put your drill bit where you want it. Don't try to drill this thing without that pilot in there. It's a little extra expense for some companies, but the way it goes. And there you go. When you're looking for a dowel, when you find a dowel or you find a bit, make sure they're almost exactly the same size. I'm going to wedge this in there and it's going to stay because it's going to fit just snug, but you can also use a little glue. Remember that birds are going to be in here and they peck and eat things they're not supposed to sometimes. Make sure when you finish this thing off with glue or even paint that it's non-toxic. Otherwise, what's the point, right? Find a spot somewhat center on your hole, somewhat below your hole, and punch it through. Just like that. Come in with your dowel, kind of measure about how far you want, and then cut it off. Now with that, I'm going to probably need some wood glue. It's nice and snug, but it does need a little grip. Now, let's flip it over. On the back, you want to drill two pilot holes. Now remember, this is going to sit at the top where this is going to rest on the top of a beam. So I'm going to put them a little lower. And I'm not going to make them very big. I'm going to use the same screws I used to put this thing together. Now, two is one, one is none. I've got two screws. I need two screws. Drop one in the dirt, you're walking back to the shop. Get a couple more. Now, before you go on out to hang this thing up, go ahead and take the front off. Now, why do we attach the front in the first place? Number one, to make sure we did it right. Number two, so we can drill these two holes. Got it. Now, as you well know, things get in the way when we're talking about a drill. If you've got an extender on it, you're fine. If not, you may have to disassemble a little bit more to get this thing connected to your post. Let's go out and hang this dude. Now you want to find an area that it's not visited too much, that doesn't cause too much disturbance by our interference, if you know what I'm saying. I'm going to put it on the fence that I built. Now I put the little birdhouse up raw. You can go ahead and paint it, stain it, whatever, but be sure to use non-toxics. Redwood would be a cool wood to use, but I use pine. It's nice and cheap and expensive, and you make a bunch of these little dudes. They'll last a season or two, if not more, and look fantastic. Another way you can encourage birds on the homestead and actually give them a helping hand is to get one of these little cages like this. This is where they put these little breads or other kind of foods, but these little baskets work great to take some fabric, some things that you've got laying around the house, some old yarn, string, whatever you've got, and just fill it up in here like so, close it, and we're going to hang this. And what they'll do is they'll come in and pull these pieces out. That's pretty long, just showing you as an example, but most of these pieces are pretty short, kind of like that, easy to carry, fly away with, and use that to build their nest. So, birds on the homestead. Get some birds on the homestead. A lot of people have mixed feelings about birds on the homestead, and I know I'm going to get some emails, some messages saying that birds eat my garden. Yes, they will eat some of your garden. It's enticing. It's appealing to us. It's going to be appealing to them. But more so are the bugs that are going to be drawn in by your garden. You see, we're creating an imbalance. A garden is an imbalance. It's an unnatural supply of food concentrated in one small spot. Tomatoes, zucchini, peppers, onions, potatoes, you name it. Whatever you're growing, you're creating an artificial environment. Lots of water, lots of foliage, lots of nutrients. Those healthy plants are going to grow. They're going to fight those bugs off, but the bugs are going to win eventually unless you have some sort of method to control them. Birds are going to help you do that. You could use beneficial insects as well. Bugs are going to eat some of your beneficial insects. But here's the truth of the matter. You're never going to get birds out of your garden. They're always going to be there. So what you want to do is entice the right ones. You ever seen a big old crow being attacked by a smaller, more agile bird? Those smaller birds will run those bigger birds. The crow, the magpie, the raven, the things that eat the apples, take one big bite out of it and then leave the rest to rot. You see, those little birds will create a balance in your garden. So welcome them. Put a house out, get a bird bath, bird feeder. See, if you feed these birds, they'll come in. Bugs are their preferred diet. They love the protein, that juicy little morsel. Yeah, I'm not going to eat that, but they love it, so that's a good thing. From that point right now, we're going to go ahead and leave birds on the homestead. Next time, we're going to talk a little more about worms on the homestead. See you next time on Back to the Homestead.
We homestead now not because we have to. We homestead now so we're ready when we need to.
I made this.